Thank you. Thank you. So the next piece I will play is titled Echa Zonachuku. It was composed in 2010 by Chijo Kengobili, who is a PhD student of history, a musicologist himself, a PhD student of history right here in Buffalo. And he composed the music and dedicated it to me in 2010. That was the year I was graduating, getting my first degree. I was still undergraduate at the time, and he wrote the music. So part of what happens in the traditional music of the Igbo is adulations. The idea of maybe hailing people or calling their names with an instrument. If you know the Oja, a sort of woodwind instrument that they use, you know, to hail people and all of that. So actually what happens is that part of the piece says my name. So the way he would shorten the name, Eche, instead of Eche Zonachuku Ndoka, Eche Ndoka. So there is a rhythm, tudum tudum, that you will hear on the piano, particularly on the bass. So that repeated tudum tudum is the piano trying to say the name of the pianist. So I'm just saying, giving you a heads up so that when you hear that, you know what's going on in the music. So that's what the composer has done. From there, we'll go to Jamaica and play the number two of Jamaican Dance by Oswald Russell. The music itself was taken from sort of traditional music, a popular song in Jamaica, you know, that most of the people know. So the composer took it and used it as the melody as part of a set of dances, three dances actually, but this is number two. You know how you have fast, slow, fast? So this number two is like the reflective one, the one that is slow and, you know, a little bit withdrawn. So that's what I'm going to play after the Nigerian piece. So I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The lead Ghanaian composer, J.H. Kwabena Nketiah, is very well known in the ethnomusicology field, not only as a researcher, but as one of the composers and champions of African pianism. So most of the pieces he wrote in that genre were composed in the 1950s, some of them 1940s and 1960s, before African pianism became established and published as a genre and a field of study. So I've selected three pieces from his book, 12 Pedagogical Studies in African Pianism, that we're going to hear now. It's taking elements of music from his native Ghana, the drumming, the singing, and all of that. So most of the readings you would hear would be from that sort of playing, the drumming and the instruments. That's some of the things he used, the elements he used for that composition to write for the piano. So from there, we'll go back to Nigeria and listen to a composition by Innocent Okechukwu. So now we start with Nketiah. Thank you. Thank you. last two composers, Fred Honorable Soke, based in St. Louis, Missouri, born in Ghana, so Nigerian parents. His work, 24 Studies in African Rhythm, is a very important work in the African pianism repertoire, because the composer traveled to many parts of the African continent, collecting traditional music rhythms, collecting traditions, you know, the resources for compositions, and he translated some of those and worked with them as the main materials for his composition. Just like I mentioned earlier, describing the idea and concept of African pianism. So some of the pieces I selected from his work that you're going to hear, you have Okoye. Okoye is the first. You have Okoye Uje, and then the other two dances. You have Iroro, and then Ayeriomo Dance 1 and 2. So Okoye is actually a name, it's an Igbo name, which means a man born on Oye Day. Now there are four, the Igbo calendar is different. It's completely different. We have market days, four. Nkwo, Eke, Orie, Afo. So some will call Orie, Oye, depending on the dialect, but it means the same thing. And most of the markets have deities. So Okoye is a man born on Oye Day, or Nwoye. Okoye is a man born on Oye Day. Nwoye is a child born on Oye Day, but it's mostly given to men. But for women, they are called Mboye, which still points to the calendar. When I was explaining and talking about my name, our names have meanings and very deep and philosophical. So when you hear Okoye or Okafo, you would know that this person was born on Oye Day or on Afo Day, that sort of thing. And there are several other meanings to that. So, but the music itself is a sort of simulation, like I spoke about the impressionistic perspective of African pianism, to paint pictures and create impression of a place, of a man born on Oye Day, his activities within that traditional setting. So you hear this sort of dance-like music and all of that. And then that also segues into the other pieces, some from the southern part of Nigeria, where he comes from. So you hear Uje and the other dances, but they are mostly dance music written for the piano. And then from there, we'll go to the last piece by Itunu Oyewale. The two pieces, Atewo and Akeregbe. Atewo is a Yoruba way of saying clap, to applaud. So it's, you know, music for play. And then Akeregbe is a god, palm wine tapas god. So he wrote it, he says, an appreciation of the palm wine tapas god. So you have the people who climb the palm trees and get wine out of it. That's our own wine, our own most natural alcohol brewed. So that music is for that. We're going to hear all of that set together. I hope you enjoy the music. Thank you.